All right, we're back in action. Welcome to beautiful, sunny, absolutely gorgeous Santa Monica Beach, California. This is a 1-2 in pool play that might have finals implications, but also could be a pretty decent rival in the near distant future. Jason DeBiz at courtside. And on the side nearest us is Erica Forman. That's who just served the ball. And a little late with the dig. And her partner hitting right side is Linnea Skinner. And their opposition needs no introduction. It's Endless Summer Zone. At the net is Natalie Myszkowski. Ian McKoy to serve. Ian with a jumbo, and it hits the back of the line. Under the rules of volleyball, any part of the line is in, and now a quick 2-2. Is that 2-0 or 2-1? Those are the first 2 points, right?
2-1.
Okay. I thought I only saw 2 plays total, so.
Yeah, she went high line over down the
block. Right. Okay. Serve to Linnea. Up and down set. Linnea cross court. Gets the lucky bounce. That still counts in this game, and now the score is tied up at 2 apiece. Four very talented players with a pretty decent volleyball IQ. Trying to go on two is Myszkowski, and that ball goes into the tape, and now the lead is 3-2. Natalie Myszkowski, very notorious for going on two. Decent percentage when she actually has her court vision on where she's going. And there's an ace, and jumping off to a quick 4-2 lead is Linnea Skinner and Erica Forman. Serving right now an advantage side. Advantage side meaning the wind coming slightly towards us. It's diagonally left to right on your TV screen. Taping from Ocean the Strand, left to right, if you will. Trailing by one is Natalie and Eden. A little bit of a slide and over the top dug by Natalie, and Eden tries to make a move and can't come up with the ball, and now the score is 5-3. Once again, this is Beach Volleyball National Events, Queen of the Beach Showcase. Nobody up. Natalie reads it. Perfect set on the up and down, and intelligently wristing away in the knuckle is Eden McCoy. Eden with a balloon floater goes out of bounds. I'll advise, in my opinion, in light of the fact that they have wind advantage, I'd like them to serve a little tougher when they have wind advantage. Not a whole lot of wind to begin with, so when it picks up, use it. Squaring her shoulders towards the pole. Beautiful swing, but dug by Skinner. Skinner, nobody up. Snaps down the middle. And the score is now 7-4. Myszkowski thought the hitter might have hit the net, and Skinner's like, not me. Skinner with another good serve, and Eden's gonna get the majority, if not almost all of the serves. Transition. Line over off of the right hand of Myszkowski, and now the score is 8-4. One game to 21. A very good classic 1-2. Another balloon serve. That one balloons, lollipops out of bounds. You might actually hear the wind on the camera. It's picking up a little bit. Nothing too significant. You look at the trees in the background, nothing blowing. There's a very good serve by Natalie, taking advantage of the wind, gets the drop, and now they close the lead within two. There's your switch. The score is 6-8. That ball had dropped in a hurry, and There's a poke into the defense, and Natalie goes high. Nobody up. You typically want to go middle, and that's a very smart shot, but it might have hit the top of her hand and just sprayed out of bounds. By Marina Skinner to serve her partner, Erica Forman, to block. Erica Forman, a multi-talented human being, as well as a very good athlete, a theater performer in her leisure and profession, as well as an opera singer. Only 24 hours in the day, I think it's safe to say that she maximizes her time. I think when they told her you have one life to live, she took it to heart. Up and down set, no, a little bit of a floater, and there's a perfect cut and a nice drop. More of that in Eden's life. She'll enjoy some volleyball prosperity, if not success in this one set match. Nothing up and down on the cuts. Gotta get a drop. There's a serve out of the middle. Erica, up and down set, nobody up. There's a free ball opportunity. Bump set, Natalie at the net, and there's a joust. And there's a cut, an example of a cut that went up and down. Eden normally gets, but just passed her outstretched hand, and now the score is 11, serving 7. That ball's over, and hitting on 2, getting blocked, that might have been a never over, and I think the refs agree. Natalie to serve. Natalie Myszkowski, 16 years of age, gets the bounce off the tape, and now that is 9-11. And Eden thought that was a switch, and there's one more. Scratch that. I got a correction from my tech guy. Natalie is 14 years of age, not 16. As is Eden, I'm pretty sure about. Transition, looking for the technical timeout, and does not get the bounce on the tape that Natalie got on the serve. And there's your switch, trailing by 1 in the match. No technical timeout, they're going to go straight through. Trailing 11-10, there's a nice deep serve and handled okay by Skinner. Skinner goes line over, and Eden approached it on the wrong angle and got jumboed. And now the score is 12 serving 10. Linnea Skinner to serve again. She's had a pretty decent one. There's a set out of the right side, and what a gorgeous jump by Eden McKoy. Way off the ground at that time. Still trailing 11-12. It's Team McKoy and Myszkowski. There's a good serve out of the middle. Recreating her string is Skinner. Skinner goes up and down on the cut, dug by Natalie, and there's a roll off the body, which should have been called a lift, and was. And now the score is 12, serving 12. Trailing by as much as 4 points. A little bit of a momentum shift, if you will. There's another serve out of the middle. Skinner struggling with it. I'm glad she went back to it. There's a wrist away down the line, and can they transition? No, looks like free ball, down ball for free ball. Resetting is Skinner. Up and down, Skinner, cross court, Doug. Eden transition, looking for 13. Nobody up, Doug. Out of the middle again, Skinner, no. A lot of pressure being put on Linnea Skinner. Eden digging some pretty difficult balls as well as some easy ones, and continuing to serve out of the middle. I think she'll do it again. Complete momentum shift. nobody up, and Natalie with a great dig and transition has to give up the goods on the free ball. Erica out of the middle. Erica had the right idea, but in deep and fast pursuit was Eden McKoy on that, and Holly wouldn't have gotten it. Holly would have gotten the dig anyway. Now it is 14-12. Going on a 7-1 run. Skinner gets another serve. This time nobody up. Skinner goes out of the middle, dug by Eden. Eden looking for 15. Eden, nobody up. Drops it. Got it. Now the score is 15-12. Being joined by Rob McLean a little bit. Thanks for coming in on this action. You have a classic 1-2. Semifinals and finals implications, probably two of the better teams in this tournament. Skinner got a whole bunch of serves and looking for the switch desperately, and that's off of Natalie, and Eden brings it back. Free ball situation. Erica gets the set. Erica up and down. Erica gets the touch. Has to go over. Erica Forman again. Another set out of the middle. Checks the defense. Goes lying deep. Just off the right hand of Myszkowski, and they finally, at least for now, stop the bleeding. Myszkowski and McKoy on a 7-2 run. The switch is 13 serving 15. And now an advantage side is Skinner and Forman. It's been McCoy. It's been Eden McCoy, the right side. And she's responded accordingly. She's her legs are absolutely spry today. She's getting off the ground and going on two. Not a very wise move if the player who's on fire is the one putting away the ball. You gotta set your partner on that.
You sent it to her.
Yeah. And once again, what's my rule? You don't go on two unless it's something you see with your own two eyes. You know, or unless it's power. If it's power, yeah, good things happen when you hit the ball, but you're doing none of that nonsense. There's a ball that may not been hard driven. There might be an argument after this. Waiting for the play over, and what a beautiful touch. Doesn't matter. McKoy cleans up the difference, and now there's nothing to talk about.
But you know, like when you're used to playing,
16-7, 14. Yeah, so you just came in on the action a little bit. They've been serving relatively easy to each other. They've just been serving locations, making each other move left and right. Eden picked up the timing of the serve, and right now they look like a snowball going on the hill, getting bigger. And Skinner gets a much needed kill. The majority of the serves going to Linnea Skinner, both right sides, Linnea Skinner and Eden McKoy. Trailing by one in the match, 1-21. Very interesting to see. Got Rob, Coach Rob McLean here with me to break down some of these plays post volley. There's one off the string, and there's a decent set, and again getting off the ground. Doug this time. Forman looking for a kill, looking for transition. Not yet. Squaring her shoulders to the pole. Out of bounds.
Here, 16-16.
What seemed like a set long marathon is now a 5-point sprint. Yep. And the balloon works. You don't need 99 luff balloons, you just need. Score is 17 serving 16. Yeah. So we're leading by one right now, Skinner and Forman. I'm being joined by
Alyssa.
Being joined by Alyssa.
Alyssa Slagerman.
And that, wow, the ball served out of bounds. I mean, aced and head out of bounds, hit wide, and now the score is 18 serving 16. Pretty even match. They were down by as much as 4 and then won on a 7-2 run and led. And now they've Natalie and Eden found themselves trailing by 2.
You know
all 4 competitors pretty well, right?
I'm just saying.
Yeah, well enough. Actually I do.
Yeah. And there's a timeout call as we take time out. Talk to me a little bit about some of the attributes and some of the strengths some of the players bring to the court. Like, I'll give you an example, Natalie Myszkowski. Some of the things you see her do well when you played against her.
I haven't played against her much, but I've seemed like a great player. Athletically strong for sure, super fast, and very coordinated.
Very good.
Thank you.
And much improved setting the last 12 months. Eden McKoy getting the majority of serves, if not all of the serves except for maybe one.
Yeah.
And Eden has responded dramatically. Her legs are spry, she's getting way off the ground.
Yeah.
They're choosing not to block, so she's actually just wristing it down. Wrist weighing down, knuckling down. She's got a good jumbo game. All of those were clean shots, untouched.
So. They were all just very consistent.
Oh, I know. I mean, I'm saying, but...
Well, to my surprise, one of the things that I've noticed that were... I don't think either team has done a lot of is sort of tough. We got a little bit of a wound left to right on our TV screen from Ocean to Strand, if you will. And there is something we affectionately refer to as a dancing side. I'd like to see a little bit more. You know, it's something like jump serve, heavy top spin. They had a couple of balloon floaters that got aces, but right now in this match, there's only one ace apiece. So, I think as you continue to play in your careers, you'll realize one of the things that separate double and triple from open is the serve and service. Because at that level, everyone can hit. Everyone's got hands, but what separates the elite really is just a tough serve and the ability to mediate such said tough serve. All right, we're back in action. Leading by 4, trailing by 2, now leading by 2. Skinner and Forman. Linnea Skinner struggled on her side out, but now it's picked up dramatically. An extended version of now de facto timeout is stretched out by Eden a little bit because she knows she's going to get the serve. And now switching sides, Natalie passes on the Ocean side, up and down set. Natalie's got to use her wrist, and she does. A very much needed, important switch. 17-18. There's an okay pass, and this is where she struggled the last time, but wow, a very clutch kill, and how Eden got there before Natalie remains a mystery to me. If you're going to peel off, make sure you get that dig. You got to play your right shoulder on that dig. There's a strand side serve to Eden, up and down set. Eden, nobody up, and it is a jumbo light, but this time covered. Going over on 2, Natalie looking to go to 18, not yet. Skinner, left side set, goes down the middle, just past the outstretched forearm, or off the outstretched forearm of Eden McCoy. Match point opportunity number 1 for Skinner and Forman.
But a lot less than what she needs to.
Erica Forman, has got a decent floater, will she? No, she just goes easy and gets what she wants, and great fake play, good athletic move by Natalie, and now at least for 1 more point, they evade losing the match. Match point opportunity number 2, 18-20. Eden goes cross court in her serve and gets the drop she wants. Ace serve. 19-20. The coach in me says Skinner and Forman should call timeout. But there's something wrong with these young cats. Oh my goodness, the new dinosaurs in town. It's called the Shankalopolis, and now we are at 20-20. Forget John Stossel, forget Barbara Walters, the real 2020 is right here in Santa Monica Beach, California. Will they go back to her? No, they don't. I thought that was a mistake. And just out of bounds. This game, the game of inches, barely out of bounds, and now their first match point opportunity, playing at a very fast pace, getting the ball back as fast as she can to serve, is Eden. There's the pass. Up and down, blue set and tipped, and this time Eden gets the dig. And Natalie, going for it all, misses. And there's your switch at 21-21.
Oh, pepperoni and sweet potato. Oh, no pizza on there?
I'm not gonna keep it to the prize.
What a great match. What pretty cool momentum switches. Very up and down, very back and forth. And that ball is served into the net. Match point opportunity number one, two goes to Myszkowski, goes to McKoy. There's a pretty good serve. Handled nicely by Erica. Erica has nobody up, goes middle. This time gets dug for the match. Eden, nobody up. Eden just misses.
We did a selfie and a video instead
of the press lane. Eden, who's had a great deep game the entire pool play, misses that one. Hopefully he continues to go there. I mean, thus far they've all been clean shots. It's just a matter of in or out. There's not anyone within 7 to 10 feet of them. There's a short serve and handled okay by Natalie. Middle set, nobody up. Natalie has a good wrist snap. No, not that time. Looking for 23. Looking to take the lead again. Skinner. Got it. What a clutch kill. Very, very important kill. And match point opportunity number three for Forman and Skinner. They switch sides again. Natalie takes the ocean side. And this time, still goes back to Eden and has to fake jump it as a free ball opportunity for the match. No, decent dig. Natalie gives her a great set, nobody up, and there's a dig once again for the match. Skinner, no, great dig. Natalie looking the side out, free ball opportunity. Skinner's gonna get it again. Skinner, pass. Skinner, up and down set. Skinner, perfect dig by Natalie. Free ball again. All the pressure in the world and gets the touch. And Forman, cut, score, and there's the match. And the final play that was pretty much significantly resembles what the entire match was like. Back and forth, up and down. 24-22 winners over McKoy and Myszkowski are Forman and Skinner. For Rob McLean, for all of you at home, I'm Jason DeBilia, so long.
I'm just trying to be